Today we're going to take a look at part of my M3 trench knife collection and my M6 scabbard collection. All nine manufacturers of the M3 are represented, as are all six manufacturers of the M6. We'll get a quick look at each manufacturer for the M6. This is a Milsco. Two is SBL, or Service Boot and Legging Company. Next we have Viner Brothers. And LNC, which is Lyon and Coulson. Moose Company, or Moose River Shoe Company. And the last is Barwood, LJ Barwood and Company. Now, as far as M3 trench knives go, there were three basic issues. The first type to be issued with the blade dated. The knives usually will be marked US M3, then the company name, and followed by the date 1943. Two out of the nine manufacturers did not create a blade dated. I guess we'll take a look at those two first. First one is Boca. Now, although they don't have a blade dated, they still had three separate issues. The first and rarest would be the double tang, which this clearly is. It's the ordnance mark. Blade is marked US M3 Boker and Company. US M3 H. Boker and Company, USA. Knife is very sharp. Good point. The handle, again, double tang. The next knife we're going to look at is Ariel. And as I said before, Ariel did not make a blade dated. They have two different issues. That is this one, which is their first, which is the blade marked. It says US M3, Ariel, Marionette, Wisconsin. Good point. Now, pommel is pinned on. All pin pommels of the era on M3s will have two pins, as this one does. It is difficult to see, but the ordnance mark is there. Again. Okay. Next knife we'll take a look at is the Imperial. Now, Imperial is blade dated. If you'll notice, there are plastic spacers on the top and bottom of the leather handle. Imperial is the only company that did that. The blade dated and the early blade marked will have black plastic spacers, as this one does. And the later guard marked versions will have red, a reddish brown plastic spacers. All versions will also have straight leather handles, so there are many variations. They have a staked pommel, or pinned, and the ordnance mark is right there. take a look at Camillus. Now for Camillus we have two specimens. This is a blade dated Camillus. U.S. sent 3 Camillus, 1943. As you can see, it's a double pinned pommel. Ordnance mark. And the second one. U.S.M3 Camillus, 1943. Very sharp. Double pin pommel. Ordnance mark. Next, I'll take a look at Utica. This is a blade dated Utica. It's very lightly stamped. So I'll move it around a little bit. See if it can help you see the markings. Knife is very sharp, it's a good point. I don't know if you can tell, but there's a double pin pommel. Ordnance mark. Next, we'll take a look at M3 blade dated. Got the double pin pommel. And I doubt you'll be able to see it, but the ordnance mark is actually a very small one between the two pins on the back side of the knife. We'll take a look at Parablade dated case. U.S.M3 case, 1943. Same here. Case ordnance mark, which is different than others. And next we'll take a quick peek at the oddest knife in my collection. That will be this one. This is a Kinfolks. And if you look at the pin markings, you can see that This is pretty much how it came from the factory. This has never been separated. It is a guard marked, but they used an early blade dated. So it's actually double marked, and even in this condition, that would make this extremely rare. Again, USM3, Kinfolk's Inc., 1943. It's light stamping, so it's hard to see, but that's exactly what it is. Next, I guess we'll take a look at these two. And what we have here are two robes and cutlery. Now, this is the only version, only manufacturer of the M3 that I am missing a blade dated knife for. I have the blade dated an equivalent of everything except this one manufacturer. Now, if you notice here, they have the cross cannon extension that is the ordnance mark on Robeson. Now we'll put these away and we will take a look unmarked LNC. We have in very good condition blade marked Kinfolk with majority 98% of the bluing original to the knife. Your ordnance mark. Handle is in good condition. Utica. See how Utica is spelled out? Unlike the blade dated that just lists UC for Utica cutlery. Now there are two versions of the Utica blade marked. There's the rarer pinned pommel, which these are, and then they also have the Pinder stake tang, which is the more common version. And again, a duplicate of the other knife, Utica, with the pinned pommel. And let's see here. This is a regular PAL. And that'll be all. And we'll do other knives tomorrow.